global governance is not global government. So it's the way to find common strategies for nations that remain sovereign. So that's the difficult task. We have member states in the United Nations. Their sovereignty is the first principle. So how can we get them together in order to act in a common sense against global warming, for example, or against global terrorism and so on? This is one important dimension of the future global governance, namely that we'll have a top level that is universal, multilateral, and we have the lowest level, that's the national one. And we need in between levels that are regional, and UNASUR is an example of that. This can be the case on trade, for example, in having free trade regions when it is impossible to get something in the WTO, or to have it on other levels, like let's say in even political dimensions. We are promoting the notion of region also in the field of responsibility to protect, and we think that if in the region you can build some opinion or some will, it is easier then on the global level to take decisions. I think that one of the dimensions of the crisis also is the absence of a clear leadership. When it is about other dimensions like the political ones, peace and security, we know that there is a strong body, the Security Council. In the case of financial turmoils, there are a lot of different bodies who have the say or partial say, and in the actual moment we see that there's not a clear and unique leadership, and I think this is one element of the problem. I think that Argentina has experience because itself had a major financial crisis about 10 years ago, and what helped finally Argentina to get out of this situation was to apply a strict discipline. And we see that the problem or the countries that have problems are mainly those who have not been able to apply very strict discipline.